welcome. Within the last few years, a new term has flooded into the public lexicon, and the frequency of its use is matched only by its abuse. You will usually hear it enter conversations like this.
Wait, you lose the money when you transfer?
Yeah. You lose the gold, yeah.
But they changed that.
No. No, that's how it's always been.
No, you kept... No, no, it has not.
Yes.
No way. No, you kept money between levels.
You did not keep it from world to world.
What? No, of course you did.
You guys are gaslighting me.
Gaslighting. It describes the act of presenting false information to someone with the intent to make them doubt their own memory or perception of reality. It comes from the 1944 and 1940 movie adaptions of the 1938 stage play Gaslight, which centers around a woman who's manipulated by her husband into doubting her recollection of events in order to hide his identity as a murderer and a jewel thief.
Yes, you're right. That's when it began.
Yes.
I can see you still, standing there, and saying, "Look. Look at this letter," and staring at nothing.
What?
You had nothing in your hand!
Now, I was in the marketplace of ideas, seeking to invest my own 2 cents, at the time this concept became the latest hot ticket item. People were buying up shares in gaslighting left and right, each eager to flip it for a quick and dirty profit, all in pursuit of their own personal brand of political demagoguery. And it was amidst this mad buying frenzy that I could not help but become increasingly aware of the fact that nobody was using this term correctly.
I'm willing to maybe admit maybe you didn't keep your gold between. I'm starting to maybe think that maybe you didn't.
No, you're willing to admit the truth now. That's good.
Don't get down on me for having a growing moment and admitting I was wrong.
Growing?
Every single person I have ever seen invoke this term in an argument, without fail, shamelessly abused it. The claim that your opponent is gaslighting you is a threefold proposition. Firstly, it asserts that the opposition is presenting false information. Secondly, it asserts that the opposition is knowingly attempting to deceive you. And thirdly, it asserts that the opposition is attempting to undermine your grasp on reality. The purpose of gaslighting is to sustain a particular narrative, not simply by being wrong, not simply by lying, and not even simply by revising history, but by discrediting counter-narratives through a dishonest appraisal of the creator's ability to perceive and report facts. Now, gaslighting is an exceptionally callous tactic to employ as a means to get your way. It's borderline sociopathic. But permit me to suppose, for just a moment, that the people who falsely accuse others of gaslighting may actually be worse.
Hey, did you ever look out at what's happening in the country these days and think that you must be going crazy since you, or at most, you and a couple of your crazy friends seem to be the only ones that think that the whole world has just gone mad? Well, first, you're not alone. Second, you're not crazy. And third, it's not an accident. This president and his entire administration are gaslighting the American people, and so far they've done a hell of a job of it. Well, what does that mean, gaslighting? Well, here's a Wikipedia definition that's as good as any.
There is not enough red in the light spectrum to color all of the flags this video raises in those unedited 30 seconds. Right off the bat, it patronizingly tries to make you feel different and special, tacitly suggests that they're on your side before you even know what the video's about, generously identifies your shared enemy with an insufferably smug image of a politician, straight up accuses them of doing something to you they have no way of approving, then sees fit to lecture you about the truth by unironically sourcing Wikipedia, which doesn't even support the claims they are ultimately making. This guy brings up Obama's broken promises with the Affordable Care Act and Clinton shifting blame during the Benghazi investigation, casually conflating lies with gaslighting. Clinton and Obama aren't just lying anymore. No, their explicit intent is to make you question reality and believe you've gone insane. This is an absolutely baseless character assassination and a total violation of the principle of charity. And I don't even like these guys, and yet here I am defending these guys because their actual faults aren't enough for you. Yet again, you have endless reasons to criticize real things your political opponents have done. Literally all you have to do is tell the fucking truth, and yet you still can't help but make shit up. This is like blaming the pitcher because you struck out in a game of t-ball. But that's not even the worst part. Let me play for you what I believe is the most insulting thing people who abuse this term do. This is from a video entitled 10 Gaslighting Signs in an Abusive Relationship.
5. Making you doubt yourself. When someone says something over and over again, you are bound to believe it eventually. Because of frequent exposure to such comments, you will find yourself questioning your own judgment and may eventually give up completely and just let the other person think for you.
Let's make one thing absolutely clear right now. There are not 10 signs of gaslighting. There is only one sign of gaslighting, and that is the one which satisfies the definition of gaslighting. In this video, that's number 9, making you question your sanity. Making you depressed is not a sign of gaslighting. Calling you oversensitive is not a sign of gaslighting. Having a selective memory is not a sign of gaslighting. Making you doubt yourself.
When someone says something over and over again, you're bound to believe it eventually.
Why?
And may eventually give up completely and just let the other person think for you.
Why would they do this?
Because of frequent exposure to such comments, you will find yourself questioning your own judgment.
And there it is. That's the bit that pisses me off. Because no one tries to prove the other is gaslighting them. It's just something they use as a flat contradiction. Whether you're just giving your own perspective, stop gaslighting me. Whether you're comparing your perspective to somebody else's, stop gaslighting me. Or whether you're asking for any evidence which supports their perspective, stop gaslighting me.
Because of frequent exposure to such comments, you will find yourself questioning your own judgment.
Is that it? You're beginning to doubt yourself? You're beginning to question your own judgment? What a horrible thing, to think that you might actually be wrong for once. Imagine the level of conceit, the sheer arrogance a person has to have to find themselves on the receiving end of a persuasive argument, to tacitly admit that it's challenging them to question their preconceived conclusions, and then to identify that as someone attempting to victimize them. There is no dimension of reality in which this person can be mistaken. There could never be any fault in their reasoning, no claim they could make that isn't absolutely true. And so when they inevitably open their mouth, having never before opened their ears or minds, they get called crazy. They have their beliefs challenged, and in a rare moment of introspection, they momentarily question whether their perspective up to now has in fact been based in a genuine comprehension of reality. Nah, they're just gaslighting me. The value of the term derives not from its intended use, but its misuse. It is not a tool in the belt of the studious orator. It is a weapon in the arsenal of the worthless obscurantist. The political partisan looks on this word as a gleaming sword, gifted to them from the Lady of the Lake. With it, they can contradict their enemies, brand them as liars, and impugn their motives, all in as little as 3 syllables. And that's more bang for your buck than even dog whistling, which this video could just as easily be about. Do not suffer the fool who raises gaslighting as a defense against scrutiny, and skewer them for what it is that they are actually presenting. A brazen confession of their own psychological depravity. This person deserves nothing but absolute disdain, and to wallow in the shameful mire they have produced of their own coagulated integrity. If you try to drag me to hell with you, don't expect your knuckles to go unscathed. Once again, and as always, bring an open mind. Leave your taboos at the door, because nothing is immune to criticism. Question everything. And thank you very much for listening.
Better hurry. Get the knife down the drawer. Cut me free and give them to me. Quick, better. Cut the rope here. Take the knife.
Knife? What knife? Are you suggesting this is a knife I have in my hand? Have you gone mad, my sane husband? There was a knife, but I lost it. I always hide things away because I'm mad.